Continuing our discussion from the previous episode, in this episode, we will discuss how we can actually divide the paid source that we have saved in the temp variable into two parts. One part that contains the data, the historical stock data that we want, and the other part that does not contain the data. So let's begin our discussion. So what we'll do is we'll just come to the next line and we'll define a new variable called temp1, and we will then use a function called strsplit. Now strsplit is a function that actually helps us to split a string into two or more parts, okay? Now we will use strsplit to split the paid source we have in the variable temp, and as we know that we have the important data, that is historical data, after the string historical price tool over here. So what we'll do is we will just copy and paste this entire phrase from the paid source to MATLAB here within single quotes, so that MATLAB is able to actually locate that string and then divide the web page into two parts depending upon where the string is. So if I just run this code, you will find that within temp1, I have two values. So as you can see, the temp1 is now a 1x2 cell array, and within that, within the first one, the first element, you will find that we have the unimportant bit of the data of the paid source. So the first part does not contain the historical stock data that we want. If I open the second part, I'll find that I have the historical stock data that I'm looking for, and I can recognize it by looking at the term date over here, followed by a very long number, and then opening quotes and so on and so forth. So now you can be sure that the important bit of the paid source is actually saved in the second element of temp1, right? So what we'll do is we'll just redefine temp1, and we'll again, what we'll do is we'll just save in temp1 the important bit, or the bit that we can use later for further calculations. What we'll do is we'll just save in temp1 its second element. So this would just remove the first element and keep the second one. If I run this in the command window, you will find that in temp1 now we only have one element, and that element contains the historical stock data over here. Alright. So before I go any further, I'll just increase the font size of my command window so that even those who are watching this video on mobile phones will be able to watch it. I'll just make it 14. Okay. So far what we have been able to do is we have been able to actually read the web page from the Yahoo Finance website, and we have been able to actually store in a variable that section of the web page that actually contains the historical stock data. So we can now stop our discussion over here, and I will let you actually experiment with the function strsplit a bit more by actually changing the phrase over here and checking out how the value saved in temp1 changes. So you can do that after you have finished watching this episode, and we'll continue our discussion in the next episode, wherein we'll learn how we can actually extract each row of the table and save it in a variable. Till then, it's bye bye from me.